What's going on? Boxing Rampage. Vlaco here. Taking a little ride in the city right now. Sorry guys that we haven't made any videos, but my boy JC been busy with work. Got the game going on, so the crowd is kind of a little crazy. So let's talk a little bit about the PBC fight. We got Lara versus Boucher or Yasha, however you pronounce his name. For me, that's going to be an interesting fight. Why? Because I believe Lara. Lara's not the guy that fought Canelo, you know. Like, Lara is not near where he should be. I think he's slower now. I think he had lost legs. So I don't think he's the same. So it's gonna be. I still pick him to win, but I don't think it's gonna. I think it's gonna be a real close, interesting fight. Gasha does have a really good pedigree when it comes to amateur's career. The kid have skills. And I think he could keep up with Lara, who had been inactive lately and haven't fought stellar competition lately. So I still pick Lara to win. He's the household name guy, and in order for Gaucher to beat him, he gotta beat the man to be the man. So I don't think you're gonna get the decision against Lara. That's impossible, and I don't think he packs the power to KO Lara either. So he's gonna go to decision, and Lara's gonna get a 7-5 kind of decision. I think 7-5. The more benefit towards Lara that I'll have is probably 8-4. So that's the main event. On the undercard, we have Charlo versus Lumen. Good fight, man. I think that's going to be the show of the night. I think that that's a 50-50 fight. I think that I won't be surprised if Lumen pulls the upset. But that fight, I gotta go with Charlo. Why? Because Charlo is the guy who got the better experience. I mean, he had fought the better opposition, and I think he have learned more. I think Lumen is still a bit green, and he's up there also, but I think he's a bit green, and that could cost him the fight. I'll pick Charles to win, but if Lumen pulled an upset, I won't be surprised. It's that kind of fight. I gotta go with the guy who had shown more, who had fought better competition. And I'm sorry it's dark, man. I'm driving, and there's a lot of cops around. I don't want them to pull me over for the light in the car. But that fight's gonna steal the show. I think that's gonna be the fight of the night. And the card under that, I mean, Trout versus Hurd. I think that's a great fight as well. Believe it or not, I think this is gonna be the best card that PBC had put together as one. You know, these are all belts right here. These fights are for belts all of them, and I think that Hurd is a big dude, and for me, he's gonna be bigger than Trout. And if Trout would have been active, I would have picked Trout to win this fight. Why? Trout Hurd is good, but I don't think he's as good as Charlo, man. And if y'all remember the Trout versus Charlo fight, Trout looked good in that fight, losing, but he looked good in that fight. He was up there with the young dog, you know. So I could see Charles Gibbon heard a lot of problems. But I could see either a controversial decision for Hurd. And as much as I like Trout, you know, that's my boy. I he's one of my favorite fighters. I always always root for him since day one. But you know, he have been inactive. If maybe the Trout that fought that type style that fought Charlo comes in Saturday night, I think Trout could get the upset or make it really close, and in the eyes of a lot of us, he won the fight. But I think Hurd is gonna get the decision. Hurd is an upcoming fighter. He's a young cat at this point. Charlo is just a gatekeeper, so I would have to go with Hurd, man. I mean, as much as like my heart want to go for Trout, but I can't. I Hurd, because Hurd is the younger guy. He's a younger bull, and he don't know how to lose yet, you know. But let's see. This is gonna be a great event, man. I think this is gonna be a great card. I can't wait for Saturday. So those are my prediction for the Saturday fight. Like I said, I'm sorry we haven't posted up videos. I've been working all the hours lately. JC got a different schedule. He used to have a flexible schedule, but now he got a really, really crazy schedule, and I think it's gonna be a while for him to come back. But I'm gonna try to at least come and give you guys my thoughts on the big events. You know, I know boxing's gonna die out a little bit for the next couple of months. I mean, next month or so. It's nothing major coming in. The Ortiz fight fell off. That was a fight I was looking forward to. What I think about that, I mean, Ortiz's team should have known better, because this is a guy who's been popped before. And once you've been popped, and even, you know, he'd be saying, no, that was a mistake, they gave me something, da-da-da-da-da-da-da. If you already went through that, you got to be cautious with whatever decision you make, you know. You can't just go out there and not put everything on the table, you know. You got to make it legit. But that's what I think about that. I mean, WBC pulling it off. I mean, Wilder did say he will fight him, and they should have continued. But I don't know. I think WBC at this point is covering their back, because so many things that have been going on with Wilder and guys that he fights, like Povetkin and Wardrix or whatever his name is. But that's that for that. Cotto fighting Ali. Saddam Ali, I mean, Cotto fighting Saddam Ali, I mean, what can I say? I mean, I think as far as my understanding, Matisse was offered the fight, he turned it down. Mikey Garcia was offered the fight, he turned it down. I keep hearing Easter is the guy that might face him, and that's a good fight for me. And if y'all think about it, Golden Boy had a deal with Cotto, and they're gonna put a Golden Boy guy on that fight. You know, nobody else is gonna fight him. Lemieux might end up fighting Saunders. That's a mandatory now. So him fighting Cotto fighting Lemieux made no sense, due to the fact that he would not. Lemieux probably would have made a little bit more money, but he wouldn't gotten a belt. If Lemieux is able to get a belt, he will definitely fight Canelo. So in the long run, Lemieux will make more money. And plus, I don't think Cotto is wanted a high risk, low reward type of fight. Why? Lemieux doesn't really make that explosive type of money. So he would have gotten a beating. He probably would have won. I really doubt it. I think Lemieux's too big for him, and that guy could freaking punch. And Cotto don't want to take a beating. I mean, this is an easy fight for him. He'll probably knock out Ali in the first round. Ali's too small for him. I like Saldana, man. He's from Brooklyn, from my hometown, but he's too small. He should. Saldana for me is a 140 fighter. You know, he's the type of guy that can't make the weight. He's like Paulie Malignaggi, a guy who belongs at 140, but fought at 147 because they didn't want to push himself to the limit to make the weight. For me, Saddam is a small fighter, man. That's it, guys. I mean, I've already been 10 minutes. I don't want to overwhelm you with my thoughts. I think the dynamic is different without JC next to me. But and like I said, we're gonna take he's gonna take a little time off until you get his schedule back together, and then we'll take it from there. I appreciate your support. I haven't been posting anything on Boxing Rampage, Instagram neither. You know, I just been MIA, but you know, I've been working, making that money, so I could go out to the fights. You know what I mean? Or I could buy those pay-per-views, like expensive pay-per-views, $80, $100 for pay-per-views. You know. But thanks again, guys, for the support. And enjoy the fight Saturday night, man. Thanks.